Hi, my name is Kevin Priestley, and I'm an Esri instructor. Today, we're going to look at configuration options for a network dataset using ArcGIS Pro. Now, in the map, I have a series of points that have been loaded up, and we're using the route network analyst solver to go from point 1 to point 2 to point 3 using a travel mode that's known as drive time. Now, this drive time travel mode requires that drivers abide by one-way restrictions, and that's why we have this somewhat looping path to get from point 1 to 2 to 3. So rather than drive, what would happen if we established a different travel mode, such as walking, and compared our results? To do that, we need to create a new travel mode. I'm going to go over to a different project in ArcGIS Pro, and I'm going to open up the network dataset that's referenced in that map, access the properties of our network dataset, and by going to travel attributes, we can define a new travel mode. In this case, we're going to create the new travel mode and we'll call it walk time. Type is walking. The impedance that we will use we'll define later. And we'll also add a restriction to prevent pedestrians from going on network segments they shouldn't access, like freeways and on-ramps. We'll go to our cost tab and we will add a new cost. This will be walk time. And this represents the distance in terms of time that it'll take someone to traverse a given edge segment. Now, we are going to use a data set, in this case, the center lines data set that defines the network, and point to a field within that data set. In this case, there is a field called the time field, and that represents the time in minutes it will take the average person to traverse one of the segments in our network. Under restrictions, we're going to establish that restriction that prevents pedestrians from accessing certain components of our network. We will look at that same center lines data set. We're going to use a field script. And this time, we do have to get a little bit more complicated. The result is actually going to be a function that we describe. We called noPeds. And for our code that we're going to use is a little bit of Python. And all that this code is doing is saying that the function noPeds is equal to the F class or functional classification attribute field on this data set. In situations where the functional classification attribute value for a given feature is A63 or A10, that means that no pedestrians is true. In other words, pedestrians are prohibited from those segments that have an attribute value of A63 or A10 on the F class field. Now we can go back to our travel modes tab, define the impedance for our walk time, and we will turn on those pedestrian restrictions. Now that we've configured our new travel mode, we need to build our network. And with our network now built, we can go back to that previous map. Now we can go to our analysis tab, expand our network analysis tools, and create a new analysis layer using the route solver. Now with our new route solver, we'll have multiple travel modes that we can choose from. And so if we look at our same problem from previously, we can create new stops. Change our travel mode and run our analysis. We have a much more straight line approach than if we were to use drive time and solve our problem. This has been configuring a network dataset using ArcGIS Pro. Happy mapping, everyone.